The iPad second generation that's going to be released on March 11th, is it really worth it? Hey guys, it's Jacob from The Latest Tech. Today in this video, I'm either going to persuade you to get the iPad second generation, or I'm going to persuade you to not get it, wait, and wait till the fall for the iPad third generation. So some of the things that Apple will be probably putting into the iPad third generation is a higher resolution display. Right now on the second generation of the iPad, they kept the same resolution as the first generation iPad, and it's not that great of a display. It's pretty good, but it's not that amazing. So improving on this would definitely make it so Apple could either make a double the pixel screen or a quadruple the pixel screen, which would make it a retina display like we see on the iPad Touch 4th generation or the iPhone 4. Another thing that we may be seeing and definitely could be seeing is better and higher pixel cameras for the front and rear facing cameras. Right now on the iPad 2nd generation, we see a 720p HD video camera for the rear facing camera. That is pretty good, but the megapixel part of that is very low. Not as good to compare to the iPhone 4, which is a 5 megapixel camera. They could definitely improve on this by making either a 4 or 5 megapixel camera. As far as the front facing camera goes, it is only a VGA resolution. So changing this would be so easy for Apple, and they could either make it a 2, 3, 4, maybe even a 5 megapixel camera, which would be great for FaceTime on the iPad 2nd generation or 3rd generation. Another possibility is a higher processor. Now, with the release of the iPad 2nd generation, we did see Apple come up with a huge processor refresh, which is making Apple put in the Apple A5 chip. Now, with the iPad 1st generation, we saw the Apple A4 chip. So, with the iPad 2nd generation, we did see the Apple A5 chip, which made it up to 9 times faster and amazing faster graphics. So Apple couldn't really improve on this unless they made maybe an Apple A6 chip or something, but that's very unlikely. Another thing, a great thing that we will be seeing in 2011 is more capable products to work on either AT&T's 4G network or Verizon's 4G LTE network. So this summer when the iPhone 5 is released, we probably will be seeing a iPhone that is available on those two networks, and making an iPad that is compatible on that and 3G and Wi-Fi is definitely a plus for Apple and Verizon and AT&T. So look forward to that. The last thing is Apple can make this cheaper. Right now, the entry-level iPad is $499. They could make this down to $399, but of course, Apple would have to cut something down about the product, and that would probably be the screen size and the general size of the product. So right now, the iPad second generation screen is a 9.7-inch screen. With Apple cutting down the size, they'd probably make it that rumored 7-inch screen, and that would probably be one of the perfect fits for the iPad 3rd generation. I want to thank you guys for watching. Feel free to subscribe above, and I'll catch you guys later.